We shall follow whatever you have just told, that 10 to 10:45, 10 minutes for converting to PDF and uploading. So uploading, you said email is a another option. So we shall consider that email option also, right? And this is for writing part, and this is for 10 minutes for this thing. And primarily, what was covered till last week? Only direct question as per what is covered this week. And so this perhaps is not required. We shall follow whatever you have done before, that you said Google Meet and all, and mailing the questions to the students. Probably we don't need this one, right? Is it okay? Trial run is not required. No, it is a. Is it okay?
Sir?
What I'm asking is, no trial run is required. I mean, we shall follow whatever you have done before, that Google Meet and things like that.
Sir, actually this Thursday I have to visit the airport to get my grandmother. Would it be possible to shift it to next week?
No, not at all, not at all. We shall conduct viva for you, half an hour viva.
Okay, sir.
If you submit an application through your faculty advisor head, whatever is required, formal thing. If anybody misses, we shall do whatever is advisable. Okay. Every day, somebody or the other will have some problem. Is it fine? Right. So we start. So this is again, we shall start with something which you have studied in signals and systems, jet transform, and then we shall take it to the next level as required in DSP or understanding of the systems and things like that. Okay. So because it is a next level course, but again we shall begin slowly from whatever you have been exposed in your earlier course, signals and systems course, right? So the initial part will be all revisiting, so we shall move a little bit faster, and unless you ask me to slow down if you face any difficulty, and later on we shall spend a bit longer time on anything new that you may encounter. Okay. So,
Sir, can
yes,
I
please.
tell one thing? Like, we were actually not had not covered the Z transform in our signals and systems course due to the pandemic.
Sure.
Yes, sir.
So, what were the thing that was covered in your signals and systems course in the discrete time signals and systems part?
No, sir, like we had done till DTFT and then after that the class was not continued.
Okay. Not continued means in classroom manner, but then some this thing was there. I mean, just I'm right. Okay. That was a difficult time, and suddenly we had a transition. So probably in the online mode also, I mean, there was some issue to get adapted to, or something could not be handled the way it was supposed to be handled. Okay. Okay, I shall give you reasonable time then, right? But then still we shall try as much as possible to move fast in the initial part. You will see that it is mostly extension of DTFT, where if we have understood DTFT, less of a difficulty. For a system or LTI system, we have seen that if xn to the system, input to the system is xn, done it that manner, that n minus k, etc. Okay, that summation over k, right, hn, then e to the power j hk, this was there, then e to the power j omega n came out, right, and the rest of the term was h to the power j omega. Do you remember that? Can I get audio response? Using convolution relationship, if xn is input and yn is output, and between xn and yn, this is the unit sample response of the system hn, then yn can be obtained from xn and hn through convolution relationship. And if I replace xn as e to the power j omega n, then I get yn from this convolution relationship, where e to the power j omega n terms comes out as it is, and the rest of the term, where k moves from minus infinity to plus infinity, and hn and e to the power j omega minus k is there, that is considered within the DTFT relationship h to the power j omega. Do you remember that? Can I get your audio response?
Yes.
Great. Good. So, we can consider, instead of now j e to the power j omega n, similar convolution relationship, okay, j to the power n, and we are writing j in the form of, you know, r e to the power j omega, j omega, okay. Then, by same thing, you can work it out, you can see, since I considered this as a review, so I didn't go into the derivation part. Many of these things, derivations, I have not gone because of my understanding that it is a review. So I will request you look at the textbook. These are very simple, and I said it is direct descent of DTFT with a difference that there is a R coming into picture. Okay, earlier you handled only e to the power j omega, now you are handling R e to the power j omega. So this is the difference. So these derivations, etc., will just follow whatever has been followed for DTFT. With this change, okay. So in that case, you will see that yn can be written as j to the power n hz. So whatever comes within that summation over here, so we write and we say that it is hz, okay. So while this is for hz, that relationship, so hn n is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity hn j to the power minus n, okay. So for general cases, so that could be xz also, yz also, so anything where we have the sequence and j to the power minus n, n varies from minus infinity to plus infinity, we can define it as z transform of this, and left hand side we can write capital X with within, you know, the variable is z, because n is consumed, minus infinity to plus infinity, all the values of n are considered in the right hand side in the summation. So this is your standard z transform definition, okay. This is your z transform definition, where z is r e to the power j omega, and this comes from convolution relationship directly. Now, what is the significance of this r e to the power j omega? So the significance of r e to the power j omega is that if you consider z, this is a complex quantity. It has got, you know, this cos omega plus j sin omega part, right? So the real and imaginary, if you plot it in that manner, okay. So this r stands for the distance, the radius, okay, from the center point, this origin, right? So over here, so this is your r, okay, over here, this is your r, and this omega, right, you must have studied this thing in your math course or so, so this kind of concept, isn't it? This polar form of representation. Can you get audio response? You know what is r e to the power j omega? How?
Yes, sir.
Right. So it will be easier. Okay. So that, you know, we have many interesting things to cover in the course. Okay. So if you know or exposed to something, we can move fast. So r stands for this length. Okay. This length. Right. And we consider counterclockwise in a positive sense. See, counterclockwise. So somewhere here, right? So if we go, then we have positive sense, right? Omega angular, you know, displacement we have considered. This side, if we go, it is minus, right? In the clockwise is minus. So that is that. And if you make r is equal to one. R is 1, then you have our standard DTFT. So this is e to the power j omega. So DTFT is the space transform. So if you substitute R is equal to 1, so this one, right? Then so it has another name. It is called unit circle. So in the unit circle is of great significance. We shall see its various other significance also. Other than that, if you travel along this path, you will get the DTFT of it. Understand the periodicity part of it also, that you are starting from here, omega is equal to 0, r is equal to 1, so that part is already considered. Then you come here, pi by 2, this is pi, then 3 pi by 2, this is 2 pi. Again, it repeats, right? So this periodic aspect is also quite evident in this representation. Okay, so summarizing, jet plane, real, this is imaginary. This is the representation of r e to the power j omega. This is unit circle where r is equal to 1. And for any other case, any other value of r, okay, or any other value of omega, you will be having some such thing, right, where r is the distance radius and omega is whatever omega you are talking about. Okay. So you can see that here we can take this r inside xn, and this is e to the power minus j omega n, our the standard, you know, the DTFT definition that we had done before. So basically you are doing DTFT in that sense of xn r to the power minus n, right? In another way, if you look at it, for now this r, okay? So this r is a value, right? Which can be depending on its value. So if it is a 0.5, and if it is a 2, right? So you are multiplying this with xn, so x0, right, multiplying with the first value is 0.5 to the power minus 1, that means 1, so this is x0, so you get x0. Then for x1, sorry, you get x0 only, right. Next one, what will you get? Can you tell me? R is
0.5.
2x1. 2x1. Next one.
4.
4x1. 4x2, sorry. Right? Dot, dot, dot. And for R is equal to 2, first one is x0. Next one. So all 1 upon 2x1, right, good. Next one?
1 by 4x2.
X and so on, right? So basically you are doing so-called DTFT or finding a summation, in fact, I mean this summation after multiplying with this. This is, this one magnitude is 1, right? Either depending on the value of r, a value which is multiplied with, you know, 2, 4, etc., or half, 1 upon 4, these are can vary. Now, if you remove this part, xn on its own, this summation may not be convergent. But if you include this r sufficiently high, like this, 2, 4, 5, etc., xn is say growing, so you are not able to converge it. But if it is multiplied with something which is reducing at a higher rate, more steeper, so the resulting one, this thing, can be called a convergent one. So DT cannot exist, but exist for certain values of R, certain values of Z. Is it clear? DTFT may not exist if xn is going like this, but when you multiply, right? But when you multiply with r to the power minus n and you pick up value of r in such a manner, I'm not talking about all the cases, I'm talking about certain cases where it is possible. Okay, then the resulting term, okay, could be convergent. And this summation exists, which otherwise would not have existed if xn was growing and this r to the power minus n factor was not there. And xn multiplied by e to the power minus j omega n is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity gives you DTFT. Now, because of this factor, the overall thing can come down, can be falling down. Is it clear? Can I get your audio response?
Yes,
sir. Please note, and that's how you will see that, I mean, other than its own benefit and all, it gives you a wider handle, wider opportunity to understand the system when you apply Z transform in comparison to DTFT. DTFT has its own use and Z transform all use. Okay. Now let us look at a few examples. So say xn is equal to e to the power n un. Okay. So you know there are signal, you are familiar with un and it is just multiplied by e to the power n. So if you perform its xz, n is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity, but since it is un, so n minus 1 to minus infinity does not count. So this summation n is equal to 0 to infinity. And this will be converging, right? If this mod z should be greater than a, right? This whole thing is less than one, and this is what you will get. Xz as this. Or you can write in this manner. And in such a case, what do we see? That xz exists. This is called region of convergence, ROC. xz exists in the region that is shaded here in the z plane. Okay? Where A is marked here, right? So A is not included. If you put A, then it will not be convergent. Right? So A is a pole here, right? And this 0, if you look at it, is a 0 here. So if you substitute Z is equal to 0, it will be, overall value will be 0. If you substitute Z is equal to A here, the overall value will be infinity, right? So if you substitute any value of Z outside this region, you are sure that it will be convergent. Okay, so region of convergence is guaranteed. Okay, if your value of, you know, the magnitude is greater than A. Okay. So in a plot where this real and imaginary object value of z is plotted, so it will be looking, it will look something like this. Is it okay? Any question on this? Here, we have plotted A to be inside the unit circle. It could be outside the unit circle also. All those significance we shall see, right, later. Is this fine? Can I get, if anyone has a doubt, please feel free. If you have not been exposed to Z transform before, then if any doubt, you can tell. Otherwise, we can move ahead.
Sir, we are saying that outside the A circle, it is convergent no matter what Z we take. And inside the A circle,
right-sided sequence, but A could be more than one also, right? So basically, these are the sample values, but there is no value going to the infinity in this direction, right? The right-sided sequence, on the contrary, right, are going in this direction, right? And values over here is zero. Or finite, after some time it is not there. Okay, so it can go to some value also, no issue, but it is not extended to infinity. Okay, similarly, right sided sequence, it can have some value in the n is equal to minus 1 minus 2, but only up to a finite length. After that it will go up to infinity. I mean, in the right hand side it is going up to infinity. Okay, so one example of left sided sequence we can consider a to the power minus a to the power n u minus n minus 1. Okay. Can I get a audio response? What is u minus n minus 1? How does it look like?
Starts from minus 1. It is 1
from minus n minus 1.
So it is 1 from minus n equals to minus infinity to minus 1 and 0 otherwise.
Okay. So now if you perform the this summation, right, then it will be minus infinity to minus 1, rest of the values since it is left sided. Right, and then you can convert it to n is equal to 1 to infinity by just substitution of variable. So make n is equal to minus k, and then with respect to k, and then just interchanging the n and k. So it will be n is equal to 1 to infinity, right? And this a to the power minus n, and this becomes z to the power n. Now you are looking for summation of this, and when you perform it, right, just the way you had done it before, okay, you just extend it, and because of this, it is a to the power minus 1 z, it is a, earlier it was a z to the power minus 1. So because of that, when you consider 1 minus over here, you get the same value, but over here the convergence, because it is a to the power minus 1 z, so z must be less than a. The convergence is guaranteed.
So your voice was breaking, you were not audible at all.
Now can you hear me? Can you hear me now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So I'm passing the microphone. Anyway, so you see, in both the cases, it is xz is, you know, the relationship, the z by z minus a is there, right? This is covered. This is, assured if you consider ROC in addition to the expression, algebraic expression that you are getting here. So when you include both, then only you have a unique Z transform for a particular sequence. Otherwise, if you exclude that, then you will see that this expression is same as this one. Okay. So this is one thing we need to know, that whenever you talk about Z transform, if we give you a sequence and then tell that what is a Z transform, you come up with the algebraic relationship, but you don't mention the ROC, then your answer is incomplete. Okay? Because it doesn't give the full information, full knowledge about the Z transform. Coming to this particular expression, this left-sided sequence, what if ROC is now not Z less than A? Okay, magnitude of A, right? So this shaded region is the ROC. Of course, this pole is not included, and there is a zero over here. Okay. So this can be extended for any left-sided sequence. You'll see that ROC is inside a circle, right? And for any right-sided sequence, ROC is outside the circle. Okay, so this is true for every other case that you will encounter. Okay, so this is a teaser. If you have understood whatever little we have discussed now, can you match to columns? So left hand side, you have been given ROC. This is Z plane. Okay, this is what you see in the left hand side is Z plane. And right hand side, some representative sequences. Okay, so you have to give me an answer that A matches with what, B matches with what, and C matches with what in the right hand side, and what is the reason for that. You can type in the chat box and then we shall discuss. You can give the explanation first. You type in the chat box. I hope all of you have got the question. We are not looking for exact values of, you know, these height and other things, right? We are just looking for, if this is the ROC in general, then it has been kind of, you know, explained there in the shaded region is the ROC. Okay, then out of this four sequences, which three are matching with which three in the left hand side? One C. A2, ABC will match with one of the three, right? Janeshwaran, A is 2, that part is okay, B is 4, and C is both 1 and 3. Okay, theek hai, I mean, that could be. Let it be. I mean, I said not all four are qualifying for, you know, so it is some extra thing could be given. Left hand side is to be matched with one of one from the right hand side. There may be extra sequences which is not matched with anyone in the left. So there could be extra, you know, thing given in the right hand side. Anyway, that part is not, you know, less important. So at least two you have got, A2 and B4. Okay, let us see what others tell and we can. So Janeshwaran has given his view. Others, you may please type. A is 2 and 3, Srishant is writing, B is 4 and C is 1. Okay. Okay. Anyone else? Consider the definition of J transform also, if so required. Okay, Mohan Lakshman has mentioned A1, B4 and C4. Achha. B and C both are 4. A is 1. So I shall wait for another 30 seconds, then we shall go into the discussion, right? Because you'll be late for next class. Okay, so whoever has answered, like Janeshwaran, you tell, or Mohan, you tell, I mean, anyone, you, any three of you, please volunteer. I mean, what could be the thought process, whether it is correct, incorrect, not an issue, but something was there in your head, in your consideration. So please tell that.
Sir?
Yes, please.
Sir, 1, 2 and 3 are finite sized, I guess. So
you tell only one of them. Anyone you start with, not all of them.
So, sir, in 1, there is negative finite and positive side finite. So, positive side would involve Z inverse and negative side would involve Z. So, Z can't have infinite and Z inverse can't have 0.
Okay. Right. So this is the justification. So what your friend is telling, who is it who just spoke? Who was it? Jalisharan, was it you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what your friend is saying, that if it is a finite duration, what will be the Z transform? So finite duration, say if I consider, say, 1, 2, 3, only this much, rest is all zero, right? So if I go by this summation, then it will be, first one will be 1 plus 2 z to the power minus 1 plus, what is it, 3 z to the power minus 2, right? So if I just consider this is in a pole zero format, right? So there will be, you know, some thing over here, no? Some z square, etc. Right? And some value over here. Okay? So that is your, that takes away the pole, z is equal to zero part. Right? Am I clear? So there is no convergence for z is equal to zero if it is right-sided, but finite duration. And similarly, if it is left-sided, say minus one, so this is one, right? Then say minus two, minus three. So if you just go on doing it, so it will be, xz will be 1 plus z plus z square and so on, right? Is that the thing, right? And if at z is equal to infinity, obviously this will be infinity. So if you see that both z is equal to 0 and z is equal to infinity are kept out, then it is finite duration and both sided, like 1 that is mentioned here. Okay. Good. Now what about B? And going by that logic, A is 2, right? And C is 1, both sided. What about B? B is associated with which one?
B is associated with 4.
B is associated. What is, who is speaking here? Who is speaking?
Sir, Adushar.
Why is so?
Sir, we can break the sequence 4 into 2 parts. For the positive part, we can break it into n equals to 0 to infinity, a to the power n, z to the power minus n.
Okay.
For the negative side, we can break it into some another variable, b to the power n, z to the power minus n, where mod b would be greater than 1.
Yeah. So, so basically for right-sided part of it, it is outside a circle? In the z plane, this is your ROC, and for left sided, it is inside a circle, right? So that is your inside a circle. So since it is both sided, as a whole, it said to be convergent. So this is what is the common area, right? So that is a concentric, you know, ring kind of thing, which is your there. Yes, very good. Okay. A2, because it is right sided, finite duration, z is equal to 0 is out. B4, because concentric rings, okay. And C1, because both z is equal to 0 and z is equal to infinity, they are out. Okay. And 3 doesn't have any candidate over here, right? So we stop here. Any question?
Sir, could you explain how ROC was calculated for left-sided sequence?
Finite length or infinite length?
Sir, 2 or 3 slides back, sir, infinite length.
So this one. This one or this one? Only 3, 4 slides we have considered today, 5 slides. Which one? This one?
Yes, sir. Sir, this one. Sir, in the first one, I understood that ROC in the right-handed sequence, mod Z was greater than A because in that case, Z minus A can never be 0. Is that correct, sir?
No, this series, a to the power z minus 1, okay, how do you write it? 1 upon, so first value will be 0, second value will be a by z, next value will be a by z square, next value is a by z cube. So this is a GP series?
Yes, sir.
So, right, 1 to infinity. So this GP series converges for what? This value is less than 1?
A by Z is, mod A by Z is less than, yes, sir.
Right, this mod value is less than 1. So this value is less than 1 means what? A mod A less than Z mod Z or Z mod Z greater than mod A?
Yes, sir.
So that's why in the Z plane, what does it mean? It is right hand side because it is a real and imaginary you are plotting. It's a polar kind of plot. Any value is a radius is there. And over here, left hand sided, it is Z by A. This, if you take this particular sum.
Yes, sir.
It was Z by Z. Then the first value is 1, of course. Then Z by A square and so on. You continue like GP series. Now it will be there. Whatever value you calculate and then you subtract it from 1, will arrive at the same algebraic expression. But here, this convergence is happening for what? This overall thing, magnitude of it is less than 1. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So mod Z less than mod A. So in Z plane, mod Z less than mod A is inside the circle.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes. 0 is also convergent. 0 is... Okay, I mean 0 is 0 value, it is not infinity. So this is what you see as the ROC. Is it clear now?
Yes, sir. So we are seeing from the series and not from the expression which we evaluate.
No, okay. Not at all. Yeah, right. We are looking at it from the series. Because only this assumption is applied, you are arriving at this expression.
Yes, sir.
Without this assumption, this expression will not come.
Yes, sir.
So this is the prerequisite. This is the assumption or this is the precondition.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Right. So you have to know the process.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. So we stop here because we are getting late for next class. We shall continue from here. I went a little slow because you told that this was not discussed. So otherwise, I wanted to cover a little bit more number of slides, but no issue. I mean, whatever we learn well. That is important.